Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm sharing with you all my breast cancer awareness wreath. I am using a wreath form in the shape of a ribbon that I purchased from the Dollar Tree. When you see these at the Dollar Tree, you need to go ahead and grab them if you have the extra funds, because they are one of the hot items as far as crafting is concerned. So I am using decorative mesh that I purchased from Michaels. At the time at Michaels, they only had this measurement or this size of the pink available. I thought one would be enough, but it turns out that it was not enough. And when I went back to try to get more, of course, they didn't have any more. With October being Breast Cancer Awareness Month, obviously a lot of people are going to be doing crafts with the color pink. So that's something that I should have planned ahead for. You'll see later on in the video I had to improvise, but I am going to go ahead and share with you all how I cut the pipe cleaners of the Chanel stems. I use a cuticle cutter from the Dollar Tree, and that works the best. That way you don't mess up your scissors trying to cut through that wire. So I'm cutting the Chanel stems in half, and that's a great way to save on them as well. Not having to use a whole one saves a lot. So as I mentioned before, the one roll of decorative mesh was not enough, and I had to improvise and use one of the long rolls of the decorative mesh, and the ribbon wreath didn't turn out as neat as I wanted it to because of frayed ends. Going forward, I will definitely plan ahead for this kind of thing and make sure I buy at least two or three rolls, but I really thought this would be enough. So nonetheless, I am going forward and showing you all how I measure out the pieces of the decorative mesh. You're going to measure out about 6 inches for each piece, and then you're going to roll up each piece until you have 5 of those pieces of the decorative mesh. You're going to bunch them together with the Chanel stem. Now, this is a method I've used on my channel many times before. I'll link down below my other wreath videos. In the past, it has been one of my favorite methods of making a wreath. However, I have to tell you that it is extremely tedious, extremely time consuming, and going forward, I won't be using this method, honestly, because I didn't have the time to really dedicate to it and make it as pretty as I wanted to. This is not one of my best wreaths on my channel. You'll see that it really is just not the best, but I'm the kind of person to where if I start something, I gotta see it through, even if it doesn't look the best. So that's what I did with this project. So once you get towards the end of the wreath, it's very important to go through and fill in any gaps, kind of spread the wreath apart, make it really full. This is not my best, like I said, but I still think it turned out okay for this being my first time doing a ribbon form in as far as a wreath is concerned. So thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to check out my other videos. I will link them down below. And I will talk to you again in my next one. Bye.